Hello, I discovered that many of my subscribers do not know when a new video from me is out. And it is very simple to get a notification every time when a new video from me is out. And this is the way how you do it. So if this, for example, is my YouTube homepage, so Vintage Stereo, the only thing you have to do is to click on this bell. And this is the notification bell. And as soon as I upload a new video in the future, you will get automatically a notification that my new video is online. So you will never, never miss a video from me again. Hello guys, this video is about the old Model F that American speaker from New York. And I opened these speakers to show you what is inside it in these speakers. And because I had many questions about these speakers, and I contacted also the Ohm factory through Facebook, and I'm going to show you that also. But first, before I show you the images of these speakers inside, I'm going to show you something else, and that is this. This is what I found about this model. This is on the page of ohmspeaker.com. So this is the factory page, and this is the Ohm Model F. Yes, but this is not my speaker. My speaker don't have this big thing on top. You see. This is a 360 degrees tweeter. This looks more like my speaker, but it's still not the same thing. This is the speaker I have, exactly this speaker. And but still no information on this side, yeah. They were built between 1972 and 1984, 4 ohm, but they dip lower as 4 ohm. And that's why this thing needs a very good amplifier, what I'm also going to explain you. So this is also not the thing I have. So then I went digging on the internet and I saw this thing. 40 years ago, the Ohm F speaker was a game changer, and it still is. Yeah. And this guy talked about Lincoln Walsh, the inventor, and how he died a year before his speaker came out. And so Lincoln Walsh died in 1971. Yeah. And in 1971 or 1972, a pair of Ohm F speakers, these are the original pair, yes, costed €900 a pair with a 12-inch woofer. And, okay, and this is important. According to Ohm's president, John Strobin, remember that name, John Strobin, so the letters GS, yes, the early production Fs had functional issues. They needed 300 watts to get going. And well, this is a nice story. I will place the link, this link, in the subscription box. And you have to read it. Yes, too long to talk about this. And then I saw this piece. I also will place the link of this piece in the subscription box from this video. So this guy also is, I'm not sure if it is the same guy who wrote this story, not sure, but anyway, this is, I don't understand what he writes here, you know. It's hard for me to understand. And But you see the high frequency axis orientation. Also don't understand this image. The tweeters are positioned so that they radiate high frequency energy diagonally across the listening area. Well, there's more from this speaker. But anyway, this is conclusion. Going into this review, the most pressing question was one I wanted answered for myself 20 years ago. The most musical speaker my budget could locate was the Ohm Walls 4. By today's standards, it sounds dated and colored, but since Ohm has no dealer work, I was left to ponder whether the modern Ohm Walls speaker had kept up with technology or were stuck in a circa 1983 time warp. If you own Ohm speakers and are wondering the same thing or considering a new pair, you should know that indeed Ohm has kept up with them, Jones. They still produce some of the most overachieving speakers around. Their speakers combine uncommon listen ability with some of the most musical, natural and distinctly non-hi-fi, non-razor-edge sound staging extent, coupled to the transparency of colorless performance of some of today's better dynamic designs. The Ohm Acoustic Micros are superb speakers and class leaders. By combining excellent sonics and the most room-friendly size and appearance with what Ohm refers to as full room stereo, Ohm Acoustic has produced a superb example of state-of-the-art budget speaker design. As a reviewer accustomed to gear costing multiples of what Ohm Acoustic asks for the micros, it is my greatest pleasure to borrow your editor's blue seal and bestow onto them Six Moons Blue Moon Award for transcending class and expectation in the $1,000 loudspeaker category. So this thing, the Ohm, I have to check this thing out, the Ohm Acoustic Micro. That's a smaller version, micro, but it is on the $1,000. So I have to check this thing out. They will not sell it in the Netherlands, but this is a CD on top, so you can see how big the speaker is. It's a small speaker, but according to this writer, it's a very good speaker. Anyway, I had contact with Ohm, as you can see over here. Ohm are on Facebook, yeah. They are on Facebook. Remember the video I made from that Bosch TV series? You see them over here. This is Bosch, Detective Bosch. And here is the Ohm speaker. And of course, Ohm is very proud that the producer used his speakers in this video. That's why they show this picture. Anyway, that's the page from Facebook. These are all the speakers they have, you know. And I wrote them something because this is what I wrote them. I wrote them the following. I'm going to show you. I recently bought these Ohm speakers, but they don't have the Walls driver because I can see a tweeter inside the black cover. I made this video from them. So this video I made from Audiofield demo test, one of my older videos from last year. What kind of Ohm speaker are they exactly? On the back is written Model F, but if they are no Walls driver speakers, what are they? So That was my question. What are they? I sent them some pictures from the speakers so he could see what it was. But what I did not knew when I made this video, so when you will see the video after this piece, is that I saw with some lightning that in this hood, you know, under this black, I could read the following big white letters. Okay. 2695. That is probably June 2nd, 1995. GS. GS. And what is GS? Well, GS stands for John Strobing over here. John Strobing. Yes. So, if I go back. So, GS was John Strobing. Below that a big letter B. So this was written, okay, June 2nd, 1995, GS, and below that a big letter B. Not sure what the B was for, but so I asked him what this meant, and he wrote me back that I said, that is a Walls F3. It was an upgrade that we provided when the original F driver started dying of old age. We are still proud to service them. And if yours is haven't been checked out in over 20 years, you might consider sending them in to make sure they are working properly. Yeah. So what I have is an upgrade. You can see over here an upgrade. And that upgrade is made in 1995. And it was checked by John Strobin. Yes. And so I wrote him back. I live in the Netherlands. Hope you like the video I made. I'm very big on YouTube with my vintage channel. Many of my viewers saw the first time a home speaker. So for surfers, you are too far. I explained the guy, I live in the Netherlands and it's impossible for me to send the speakers over to America for service or to check them out for working properly. And then he answered me back, our pleasure. Thanks for exposure. I thought, okay. But that's not an answer, you know. I want to know what kind of Twitter is inside, you know, which Twitter I could change this Twitter with if eventually I want to have a different Twitter, you know. And I asked him, is it possible to change the Twitters in modern ones, or are these good enough? Yes. And then he answered me. I asked him, you know, just a normal question. I live in the Netherlands and I wanted to change my, if I wanted to change the tweeters, you know, in better ones, is that if that is, well, maybe it's not necessary at all, but maybe there are now better tweeters, you know. And then he answered me, we do offer a variety of upgrades that include changing out the super tweeter, which extends and smooths out the treble, as well as making voices more natural and improving power handling. The upgrade you probably want costs $2,800. Up to you what you consider to be good enough. Well, I thought, come on, man. I ask you a question. Which Twitter I can use, you know, but he don't want to give me that answer. He wants to earn $2,800, but we forget that I live in the Netherlands. So I if somebody in the Netherlands or in Europe have to ship these speakers, that will be very expensive. You know, shipping is expensive for these kind of speakers, and then you have to pay an extra $2,800, you know, for the upgrade. And probably if he would give me Well, the name of the tweeter, you know, what goes okay with these speakers. Probably it is a tweeter maximum from $100, so I'm not sure why it have to cost $2,800 to do a upgrade. Anyway, this is the price for an upgrade, my friends, and the guy is not very helpful, you know, to give me some names of tweeters what are suitable for these speakers, so you can do it yourself. You understand? This is a business model. They want to earn money, and they want to earn big money, because $2,800 for just an upgrade, and the speakers are sounding okay, fine. So they don't need an upgrade. But I was only questioning him. You know, the last upgrade was from 1995, so maybe there are some better tweeters now. But he wants to do a full upgrade for $2,800. This is probably the minimum upgrade he give. And well, so this guy doesn't really helpful, you know, because not everybody have $2,800 in the pocket. I'm sure many people will not do this upgrade. Anyway, this is what you will miss in this video, that I could read these letters. You know, these letters, OK2695GS, it was standing over here on the side, you know. I could read it with my lamp. And let's start with the video, okay? Well, guys, today is a special day, because I will take off this thing. I will take off this thing, but before I'm going there, I'm going to tell you a story what happened today. I had a visitor. I had a visitor because I placed these speakers online for selling them. And this guy stayed in my house for about 2 hours. You know, I thought, well, you know, and the only thing he told me is, can I come to your house to test them, to hear them? I say, okay. You know, we didn't talk about the price or nothing else. It all went very relaxed. You understand what I mean? And this guy was a real audiophile, because he saw these two amps, I'm going to show you. I removed the cabinet, you know, because I have to play. I saw these two cabinets, and the first thing what he told me is, why do you use this Akai? I said, because my best amplifier. He said, no, this Amkron is the best. I said, but how do you know? These amps were never sold in the Netherlands. And then he told me, well, I know. So I told him, do you know the own speakers? Yes, I heard them before. The guy came with a bunch of CDs, and he played them over this Marantz. And well, we first test the speakers over the Marantz or over the Akai, and he was not satisfied. He told me the bass was not too punchy enough. It was not nice bass. The highs were not nice, and. But then I told him, okay, let us try the Amkrons. And everything changed after that. His face starts smiling, and he was sitting and telling how beautiful these speakers sounded. And then he went to the speakers to see if he could inside. But we could inside. Well, maybe I can give you an impression. Maybe I can give you an impression, because what is inside, people will not believe me, but there is inside a tweeter. So these are not the Wells drivers, as you can see, because the Wells drivers, they were higher. Also the hoods are higher, you know, the dust covers, they are higher. And so this is an other Model F. I'm not sure why they made those models. Maybe, well, because they don't need
that service, because those Welsh drivers need to be serviced, and this is an import version. But they also sold them in America, of course. So I'm not sure. I don't have the reason. I'm not sure if anybody knows this, because I'm the first one who is going to open for you this hood to show you what is on the side, these speakers. It has two from these things. Yes, you can screw them. I already took away the one from this corner, and then you can screw them away. Yeah. Like this. I placed them over here. And what I did then is, with this thing, but I need my two hands, because as you can see what is inside, if you can see, let me zoom in for you. You can see what I mean. There's another screw you have to take out. So that's what I'm going to do now. And if both of them are out, I come back to show you what is under this, this hood, because that's what we want to know, you know. And there is a guy on my comment section, and he don't understand. And I also didn't understand, because it was the guy who was in my house today. He told me, well, these Welsh drivers, you know, I have to check them good, because if they are broken, or, you know, it's hard to replace them. But then he saw the tweet, and then he told me, well, then it is not a problem, because a tweeter is easy to, if a tweeter breaks, you can replace a tweeter, you know. But those Welsh drivers, that there are only a few people in the world who can repair these things, you know. And if you have a pair in America, you can, well, maybe it's not that hard to let it repaired in New York. But if you live in Europe, well, nobody in Europe repair these speakers. So, but in this case, this is another, well, another kind of speaker. Not sure. I will know in a few seconds when I open the hood. And probably this will be the only video make of this underside. And I can check how it is looking, but I have to need my both hands to open these screws. And I come back when the hood is off, okay? Well, guys, and again, I have a surprise, because as you can see, this is what's happening now. Well, I think this is the hoover, and here is nothing under. I see some wool. Well, before that, I want to see what the size is of the hoover. I want to know exactly. And the hoover size is, well, that is 30 centimeters. 30 centimeters or 12 inches. That's the size of the hoover. Yeah, so the hoover is pointing downwards. Well, let me shed some light on it so I have a better view. Sure, if you can see through it. But there is really a tweeter inside this thing. I cannot open the thing, my friends. It's very strange looking. As you can see, it's not a Welsh driver. Everybody can see now that this thing is not a Welsh driver. It is something completely else. Something completely else, my friends. You can see the tweeter through. And that's what I don't understand. Oh, I have to, not to make the mistake that, let me see, this side was pointed here, yes, over there. Who did I film it? But okay, I'm going deeper now. As you can see, they use thick wires, not those thin wires. And those wires are very thick. Not sure what this thing is over here. Not sure what it is. Anyway, We go inside to see what we can find inside, but no, I want to, maybe there is more, another woofer. I don't think so. Some people say that this thing have two woofers, well, maybe on the bottom side, not sure, but I don't want to make things rotten. So this complete box, what you see here, until my hands reach, is made of this stuff. And here I feel a room. No, this is not a room, this is just wood over there. You can see a piece of wood, probably to make it more stronger. But I cannot see another speaker. Probably inside there will be another speaker. But this thing over here, you can see it. That's why the bass is so beautiful. This stuff goes all the way until the bottom over there. But in the bottom, I don't see nothing. I don't see any other speaker. So I just pointed all my spots, my four spots on this roaster, and maybe we have a better image what you can see behind me. Maybe I can zoom a little bit. No, zooming is worse. So maybe in this way you can see what I mean, what is behind the roaster. On the bottom side you see, of course, the chassis from the woofer, you know. Yeah, this is how it is looking, my friends. And it's not a horse driver, that's clear to me. But I did not know that until that guy who was in my house today, he wanted to have a look, and then he saw, hey, this is not a horse driver, because that was his concerning, that everybody knows that if you have a Walsh driver, you need at a certain moment a reparation, renovation, and that's very expensive, and only a few people on the world can do that. You know, it's not just changing your rubber foam rings. That is an easy job for most people. But this is something completely else, so a Welsh driver, you know. But this thing is not a Welsh driver, so it is more easy. Well, maybe on top you can see something, no. On top you cannot see nothing. Well, maybe from this side. Maybe from this side you can see something. But anyway, this is how it is looking, my friends. I pointed all my light, but it is still not enough. And maybe if I zoom in from this side, you can see a little bit more. Maybe I can give a little bit extra light on this side. Yeah, maybe now. You know, you can see what I mean. But yeah, this is definitely not a Welsh driver, my friend. You can see on the back side, you can see the white wall. You can see the shape from this thing, that this thing is not a Welsh driver anyway. And also, of course, the proof is here, standing over there. Yes, let me zoom in. Aim towards center of the room. So this side, yes, that means that it is not a 360 degrees. A Walsh driver. And, well, my friends, I'm very happy that it is not a Walsh driver, because if you live in America, like I told you, it is maybe more easy to repair a Walsh driver, but not in the Netherlands, my friends, not in the Netherlands. So this is it. This was the video from how it is looking in the inside, because this is a weird speaker, my friends. Strange speaker. And I didn't know it was this filled up with that stuff. Not sure what it is. And but yeah, I now know that if there is a problem with the woofer ends, that's an easy job. Not for me, but for the guys who knows what to do, you know. And well, thanks for watching this video, and I hope I put some light on this on this strange speaker, you know, more light. I didn't open it completely. Don't want to do that. I'm not that handy. I don't want to break stuff. I break more stuff than I repair it, you know. Now I have to place those screws back. I hope I can manage that, you know. These screws, I have to twist them back because they're still loose in the chassis, as you can see. It's moving now. So, but that won't be a big problem, I think. So thanks for watching. Put your thumbs up if maybe there are some guys who recognize this. What is this? This is a Ohm Model F without the Welsh driver. So, but there's no place in the do they mention this speaker? So what kind of speaker is this exactly? Sounds beautiful, but what is it? What is it, my friends? This is a extra rare speaker, I can tell you that. Anyway, I'm glad it is not a Welsh driver, for the reasons I just told you. That it is more easy. I mean, if one of the tweeters would burn out, that would be easy to change, you know. But if those Welsh drivers, if the tweeters from those Welsh driver break, then you. Yeah, I'm not sure how you can repair the thing. Not in the Netherlands. That will be a awful job, you know, almost impossible, you know. But this speaker, you can maintain. Thanks very much for watching. Put those thumbs up if you like this video. And for now, I say ciao.